that is a very specific prediction. I'm going to go with the Ryder Bronx as well. Maybe not as close as you, maybe like 12 points, 14, somewhere around there. But I think a Ryder win is definitely what the fans want tonight, because tonight's also Academic Achievement Night. So you know a lot of athletes are going to be in the building.
Obviously prefer the AEW 4 pay-per-view a year structure.
I am obsessed with that. I love going to TV every week. We don't have live events. The schedule is amazing. You have a good work-life balance.
Are you calling me a Hall of Famer? Or that is high-key not true. That's all her.
You're a virtual Hall of Famer.
Virtual Hall of Famer? I'll take that.
A virtual signing Hall of Famer.
Look at that. I just got inducted into the virtual signing Hall of Famer.
Richie. You're actually the first inductee. It's a pretty big deal.
Oh, look at that. I would have prepared a speech.
For next time, yes. I'm going to go ahead and go on record. Next signing that Kimmy is involved in, she'll be giving her Hall of Fame speech to the virtual inductee Hall of Fame. So you've got to automatically tune back in for that.
Oh, of course.
Do you think Big Ben is coming back next year?
Ooh, I don't know. I'm so torn on that. Like, when I watched the end of the game last week with the Browns and he sat on the bench with Pouncey and they were crying, I was like, oh, he's done. That's it. But then I'm like, man, I don't know. Would Big Ben go out with that performance? Although he threw 500 yards, like, we love you, Big Ben, but with no fans, I don't know. He still has one more year. It's like, what, 40 million? Would you give away 40 million? I probably wouldn't. So we'll see.
And of course, the most obvious question of all, right? You are no stranger to holding gold. What would it mean to win and hold the gold, hold the chalice, the whole shebang shebang next week?
It'll just mean that Chicago's better than the East Coast. Simple as that.
Oh, ouch.
Yep. I went there.
I mean, okay, I'm a Chicago Bears football fan, right? Okay. So I'm on your side when it comes to football, but everything else, I'm like, East Coast, let's go.
You're like the heart.
Listen, I love traveling the world, so if I could just go to Chicago, I'd be like, let's go.
I get you. Yeah, I mean, hopefully the Bears, hopefully in the next couple of years, they'll get their heads out of their butts, but... I've yet to go to a Bears game, surprisingly. That's one game. I've been to Hawks. I've been to Bulls. I've been to too many freaking Cubs games. but I've yet to go to a Bears game, but it's like a little pricey. So.
That is true. But I mean, you know, they have the number one pick in the draft. We have Justin Fields. There's momentum. Speaking of your shiny, what would it mean to you to reclaim the title that you never lost on February 25th?
Everything. That's my shiny. That's my precious. Mine. I've never stopped calling it mine. I've never stopped calling the Goddesses of War, Titans Championship Wrestling, the Realm of Riley, the Gladiator Goddess. It's mine. It's mine. And I will make it mine again. End of story. And I will prove everyone who took the time to send me messages to reach out to me, to send me well wishes about my injury, who have supported me, literally brought me back to battle, because that's what happened, having these people reach out to me and remembering all the times I've shared with them and all the stories they've shared with me and their lives and their art and everything. They're the ones who brought me back. So this is not just about me. You all brought me back. This is all for you. I'm doing this for you. That shiny is to represent that. That shiny is to show you all brought me back.
Chris Jericho is going to win because they're going to try to sell the Final Battle pay-per-view. They need a big star to help sell the pay-per-view. So that's why they're going to put Chris Jericho on it to help them sell the pay-per-view. Because it is also running the same day as NXT Deadline. But the catch is, this Ring of Honor pay-per-view will be running at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, which is such a weird time to air a pay-per-view. So that's why Chris Jericho will help them sell the pay-per-view, sell out the arena, you know, do all that funny stuff.
Kimmy, when you give me answers like that, I am so proud of you. You know, you're talking demographics, you're talking times, you're talking business. You're convinced. I was like, well, why Jerry? And I wasn't trying to be difficult. But you're just like, here's why. And I was just like, yeah.
Go on. Taking enough of Kimmy's time.
Yes, go on. In the words of the Backstreet Boys, tell me why.
So here's a fun fact. So this Saturday is actually my 12-year Mike, stop singing. This Saturday is my 12-year wrestling anniversary.
I thought you were gonna say your 12th birthday. That's awesome, Kimmy. Good for you.
So it is my 12-year wrestling anniversary. And how perfect would it be if he won?
That's just a nice anniversary present.
That is a nice anniversary after the year and a half we've had of him losing. And, you know, injury bugs make stars. Rob said it. People pop out. Rollins is that utility player. Rollins is the one that's going to climb that ladder. He's going to grab that briefcase. And I just want to say that I said for months, I pick Rollins on every prediction show. And this is the first time everyone here almost picked Rollins. That is like God sent.
That I want, and this goes into Billy Starks, is oh so long ago, there used to be this thing called the Ring of Honor Prospect Tournament.
Oh.
It used to be an 8-person tournament, and the winner would get a Ring of Honor contract.
Oh.
Some of the people that have won this have included Mike Bennett, Matt Taven, Leo Rush, Roosh, a lot of people who have been very known names in Ring of Honor. So since there's so much independent wrestling out there, I think they should bring back the Prospect Tournament. I think that there's enough independent talent out there that you can bring a men's tournament and a women's tournament. And I actually have Billy Starks winning my women's prospect tournament to get a contract. I know she's graduating high school this year, so I know she's eligible. And my men's was a little hard because obviously I would have Nick Wayne win, but he's already signed, so I can't have that. So I don't know if he's signed because Bill and I looked it up and we had mixed reports. I would have Blake Christian win my men's prospect.
Think about the strategy for the first two brackets, obviously being very early on and getting that break, but these bottom two, you don't have that much of a break.
You don't. But I think they'll be fine. I think everyone in this ring is going to be quite okay with not having as much time as, say, a JC Storm, you know, especially Cosmic. I mean, we saw the start of the match, and she just, her eyes are on the prize.
She's ready to make a statement. She's ready to come in here and make it to the finals as she's trying to right now, pinning Vicious Vicky. Only for a two count. Valentina trying to break that up because she's trying to walk out with double gold too. Like I said,
yeah.
One half of the Funhouse Tag Team Champions. Might walk out with the Goddesses of War Championship as well.
That would be fantastic.
I mean, I do love a double gold story.
Me too. Just like I love an underdog story. It's all about the storytelling, right, Kimmy?
That's why we all love professional wrestling, folks. Marie and Valentina locking up here.
Oh, Valentina, you can't ever count her out. Oh,
look at Cosmic.
Then Cosmic comes through.
That's the thing about these Fatal 4-Ways. You never know who's coming at you. You have to be alert at all times. So if you're really good at multitasking, this is the match for you. As Cosmic tries to put it away here only for a two count.
Wow.
You can't get frustrated. You see the frustration on Cosmic's face, but you can't get frustrated here. You have to just go after somebody and try to end this match as quickly as possible.
Amen.
And she found her next target.
She sure did. And she didn't waste any time. Oh, maybe it'll just boil down to, I don't know, to...